Hello and welcome to this tutorial about the ZEISS eXtended data technology. Today we will go through the workflow to record ZEISS eXtended data, distortion and shading using a Transvideo Starlite HD-m monitor and a camera. Short recap on the ZEISS eXtended data technology. It provides you lens data, accurate lens data. It's based on the Cook/I technology, which provides accurate lens data like focus and iris. But on top of this, it gives you the distortion and vignetting data, which are crucial for VFX integration in post-production. So you don't need to shoot grids anymore in pre-production. You just record the lens characteristic together with the video clips. And today I show you how it goes on the Starlite HD-m Transvideo monitor. So the big advantage of the Starlite HD-m monitor is that you just need this monitor together with your camera, and it will record the data on a SD card and will save different files, which you can just copy paste and pass through to your post-production, and they will be able to use them immediately with our plugin for Nuke or After Effects. There is no additional software needed to generate the size lens correction files. The Starlite HD-m monitor will do this for you. Before we can record the data, there are a couple of things to take care of with this monitor. The first thing, of course, is that you ensure that you have the SD card in the SD card slot. Then we need to plug the right cable. So the first one, the obvious one, is the SDI cable so that you can get the video signal. The second one is a cable that gets the metadata from the camera. This will be needed to generate the ZEISS lens correction file. So, and this you will be able to plug on the example on the ARRI camera. You will plug this to the Ethernet slot. And the last one, an obvious one, is the 4-pin lens data cable that we will plug to the external connector of the lens. So first on the display, and as you see, there are no lens detected at the moment. I will plug this to the lens, and then you see a small ZEISS logo, which means the lens has been detected by the Starlite HD-m, and you can just start recording your video clips. That's it for the setup. Now the rest is quite easy. Whenever you will record a clip, the Starlite HD-m will trigger the recording of the lens data and generate the ZLCF file. Perhaps one thing to check, first of all, if the data are read correctly. Here, when I press on the metadata display, I can see basically that the lens is recognized and the data are changing when I turn the iris and the focus. And the second thing would be to ensure that the auto rec on the display is switched on, which will allow the Starlite HD-m to trigger automatically the ZLCF file generation. So Now, once again, as soon as I will press the record button, I see on the display that it's recording lens data here with this icon. Whenever I stop the recording, the display will write the lens data onto the SD card and everything's ready. The next step will be to copy paste those files together with the video file and pass them to the post-production.